welcoming of all the provinces and the Cordilleras to push the cacao industry. I know that we will attain a better position in the cacao industry.
We look forward to more convergence with the DA CAR office so that we can move forward the cacao industry in all parts of the value chain.
But why cacao in CAR in the first place? Basically, cacao may significantly contribute to the poverty alleviation and inclusive growth through livelihood and job generation. As indicated in 2017, the 2022 Philippine Cacao Industry Roadmap that was signed by President Rodrigo Duterte last year, the industry targeted 2 kilo per tree per year to beat the 2022 cacao challenge. In line with the 10 points priority agenda of the Department of Agriculture, that includes 1, the government initiated and supported aggressive marketing campaigns, especially for high value crops in foreign market. 2, the intensive technology updating and sharing modernization and mechanization program. And 3, strategic and effective post-harvest storage and processing facility. The regional cacao summit then is conducted to advocate the investment potential of cacao production and processing in Cordillera.
I'm sure you will all agree that the Philippines is well positioned to fill in that gap, and we should work together to ensure that the industry players, like the people in the Cordillera, will be able to compete with the help of DTI and DA and most likely DAR and DOST. But DE and R has given it a go signal that they will help you compete.
Nagkaroon ng opportunity tayo dito eh, ano, malayo na, i-income tayo, no, mag-engage sa Philippine Cacao Development. So, if you will be planting in Cordillera 1,000 hectares until 2022, you multiply it up to 150,000, that will translate up to 150 million pesos na mabalik tayo ng income. That will activate at 80,000 to 100,000 na nung based on the latest na doon na computation kung study ng National Cacao Council, dito na ako tinutumot na mabalik tayong income per hectare, no, mula tayo yung kakao. So, 120,000 to 150,000. So, likewise, kung napwede targeted din yan yung export earnings at least 250 million US dollars. So, sabi ba yung dito, ito yung common challenge.
Dapat sama-sama. So that's the reason that we have that industry clustering approach. It's all about inclusion, sama-sama lahat. It's all about conversion, lahat na support natin. It's all about collaboration. Ulitin ko, industry clustering is all about inclusion, convergence, and collaboration. No industry in the Philippines kaya i-develop ng isang ahensya. That's impossible. We have to think and move as well.
The main business then was exporting the beans to a trader abroad. The trader then distributes it worldwide, some of the finished products, now in chocolate bars, would eventually find its way back to the Philippines, marketed and sold as imported chocolates.
So, kompleto ang team ngayon. So, I don't think na mag-fail ang ano, ang Cordillera region sa cacao production. Nandito kami lahat. Natutulong sa inyo kung ang gusto nyong tulungan, magpatulong kayo.